Summer is officially here in downtown Memphis, specifically AutoZone Park, as today the Memphis Redbirds are going to play host to the visiting New Orleans Baby Cakes. It has not been a home field advantage at AutoZone Park, the Redbirds dropping 20 of their last 22, including last night, despite some potential heroics from catcher Andrew Kisner, who goes deep to left center field with a 6th home run of the year, and the round tripper had the Redbirds hopeful of getting off the schneid and getting back into the win column. Swinging a hot bat for the Redbirds the last 2 weeks is John Nogowski, as he used his wheels last night to pick up not one, but 2 base hits, extending his hitting streak to 14 in a row, driving in a lot of runs here in the month of June. The Redbirds have been unable to put together the hitting, the defense, and the pitching at the same time. Hoping a boost to the rotation will be Austin Warner, just up from AA Springfield to make the start here this afternoon. Austin got his feet wet here in Memphis a year ago, looking for a boost after a strong first half with the Springfield Cardinals. Hopefully striking out guys and strutting to the dugout just like that. That's coming up in just a little bit from AutoZone Park. You could use some wind to cool things off here in downtown Memphis. I think we're on our own. We invite you to stay tuned. Memphis Redbirds baseball coming up next on CW30. Well, welcome back to AutoZone Park. Steve Selby with you, and welcome to everybody viewing this afternoon on CW30. It's the Memphis Redbirds and the visiting New Orleans Baby Cakes, the Field of Dreams team, sneaking an autograph or two before they leave the diamond. What a thrill it is for the kids to be out there with the big fellas in this big, great facility, and the Redbirds in their retro powder blues here today. And Memphis in great need of a win, as you saw in the open. It's been a grind, losing 20 of 22 here at home while having a winning record on the road. It's supposed to be the other way around, but not the case, as the Redbirds will go to the left-hander. Austin Warner made 7 starts here last year, posted a record of 1-2 with a 4.33 earned run average. At Springfield, he appeared in 15 games. He was 4-6, but a nice 3.83 earned run average. That's in 15 outings, 14 starts, 82 and a third, 83 hits, 25 walks, 88 strikeouts. He's not a big guy. He's a sub-6-footer. Will throw a lot of strikes. He's got to locate. He can be upper 80s to low 90s guy. Curveball, slider, change. His curve has a change at times. Can be a very big out pitch for him. And defensively, there's as good as there is at first base. You just saw John Nogowski. Irving Lopez, the birthday boys at second base. Happy birthday, Irving. Kramer Robertson will be at short. Max Schrock is at third. The outfield is Ravelo in left, Garcia in center, Arozarena in right, and the catcher putting down all the pitches for Austin today will be Joe Hudson. And we're ready to go here in downtown Memphis on a steamy day. Here's John Barrett. He is rehabbing from the big leagues. Austin's first pitch, and that's how you start off. Strike one's the best pitch in baseball. Barrett, 11 of 39 in his rehab, with 2 homers, 4 runs batted in. Warner's 0-1 is hammered high and deep to left field, and that ball is gone. Make it 1-0 Cakes. Onto the bluff in left field. Barrett's third, and that's as quick as you can make it 1-0. Well, I guess it could have come on the first pitch. Wow. What a start for New Orleans. They come in at 45-37. They're trying to hang with the big boys, San Antonio and Round Rock in the American Southern. They trail front-running San Antonio by 5 and second place Round Rock by 2.5 games. Also, Warner will try and regroup. There are no mulligans, but he's got to put it in the memory banks. And now he's got to deal with a dangerous guy in Lewis Brinson, hitting just shy of 300, 295. And that fastball from Warner is in at 92. Brinson, 11 homers, 45 runs batted in after a 1-for-4 night last night. 1-0 pitch, and look out, that's deep into left center field. Ravelo's going to watch that one go. It's into the YMCA parking lot. Back-to-back home runs for the Cakes, 2-0 New Orleans. 422 is the estimated distance on that one. That's his 12th and RBI 46. Ravelo just goes, oh my goodness. And there's a little dent, some personality in the
vehicle or two out there in the parking lot. Wow. Four pitches in, two homers, and a 2-0 Cakes lead. And now you want to talk about really having short-term memories. Gosman's got to put it to work right now as he faces Esan Diaz, who has 18 home runs himself. He'll take a high curveball. 299, he's driven in 52. And, oh, by the way, Diaz had a homer and three walks last night. Swing here and a smash foul into the right field corner. Boy, the second pitch of each at bat's been hit really hard, although that one was foul for Diaz. Officially one out of two last night. A little bit of a different look to that helmet, isn't it? Yeah, deep breath from Warner. What's hit him? He's got to regroup, and he's got to do it quickly. Just inside, pretty good pitch. That's Clayton Ham behind the plate today. Malachi Moore is at first, and the crew chief, J.J. January, has the third baseline. The 2-1, there's that change at 83. That's a good pitch, 2-2. Warner went undrafted. He played Division II baseball at Bellarmine in Kentucky and had to go the independent baseball route, playing in River City in 16 and part of 17 before the Cardinals scarfed him up. Swing and a miss. That's a good slider. And there's that first down. He gets that out of the way. Some pretty nice looking pitches in that sequence. There's that slider. See the front side of the lefty fly open, and then he's done if it's any kind of pitch. And it was a good one. One away for Austin Dean. Dean came on late yesterday, went 0 for 1. 338, eight homers, 33 RBIs. He goes after the first pitch, and that's Arozarena with a bit of a weight. And there are now two outs. He wasn't messing around. These guys have been aggressive the outset of their at-bats. Two gone, Peter O'Brien will face Warner. O'Brien began the year with the Marlins and back down with New Orleans. He's 254. Six homers, 15 runs batted in. And it'll be strike one. The good news is, and there's a couple, and we're paid to put the spin on it for the home club, is it's early and they were solo home runs. 0-1. A nice pickup by Hudson, even though it's the base is empty, showing his good hands. Warner is the number 30 prospect in the Cardinals system. Listed as 5'11", 185. He turned 25 just a couple of days ago. The 1-1 is a little too high. Yeah, on the 27th, just 3 days ago. Boy, we've nearly hit July. And the weather feeling like we really have crossed into the summer days, which we did recently. 2-1, and he's out in front. And that'll head down the corner. Two more games, or three more games in the series. I keep forgetting it's a five-game set. And then on the 4th of July, the Redbirds will make their way to Des Moines, Iowa. Face the front-running I-Cubs. 2-2 pitch, and oh, he started for the dugout. Shrugs his shoulders, goes back. It's 3-2. He thought he had it. Clayton Ham says, no, you didn't, son. Outfield straight away. As Warner delivers the 3-2. Hard to center field, and that'll bounce in front of Garcia and kick away, but not enough for O'Brien to advance. He'll just stay at first base. I wonder if that ball wasn't knuckling on Adolis a little bit. We'll see if the center field camera can tell us that or not. It was hit very hard. It was an off-speed pitch up and away. He just wasn't quite sure whether he wanted to gamble or not, but he kept it playable. Two-out single, gets switch hitting Eddie Alvarez to the plate. Alvarez did not play yesterday in the New Orleans 6-3 win. First pitch outside, ball one. The 349 with four homers, nine RBIs. He's swinging it, isn't he? New Orleans, a quick 2-0 lead here in the first. Low over the inside corner. Alvarez is 29. Played in the International League with Charlotte last year. He's listed as 5'9", 180. 2-0, that's too high. A scouting report from Baseball America indicates that Austin on occasion can get too much of the plate, which we saw in the first two batters of the ball game. 3-0, and he walked him on four, so two have reached after two are out. One walk to go with a strikeout. Rodrigo Vigil will bat. Right-handed hitting catcher, 162 with a couple of runs batted in limited time with New Orleans. We're in for a steamer here today at the ballpark. It's O'Brien, the lead runner at second, Alvarez at first. And Austin misses inside, ball one. Over 20 pitches already. Seventh batter of this first inning. In need of that third out. Here's the pitch, out of play. The Cakes have been playing without their exciting outfielder, Monte Harrison, in this series. Got a bit of a wrist issue. They're trying to get him well. After a check of second, a fastball high, 2-1. Well, Austin's numbers very, very good at Springfield. 82 and a third innings, 83 hits. The hits are just a touch high, but how about 88 strikeouts and 82 and a third? That gets those hits out of the way. It strands a lot of runners, what it does. 2-1 pitch, up high. And last year, for example, in his seven starts for the Redbirds, allowed 56 hits in 35 innings. An ERA of 4.33, respectable these days and in this league. Means he gave up a lot of hits. He worked from the stretch a lot, and he also stranded a boatload of runners. 3-1, and that's high ball four, and he's loaded the bases. And you're not far from a first inning visit just to give him a breather.
Now batting 23, Rosell Herrera.
25 pitches, 11 strikes, yep, and they'll send Joe Hudson, the catcher, out there, and the double play combo of Robertson and Lopez will join the party. And here comes Danilo Orozco. You're going to get a first inning visit from the Memphis pitching coach. And now the rest of the infield will join in the discussion. Game three tomorrow night, a 6:35 start. A matter of fact, 6:35s for all three games remaining in the series clear through Wednesday. Tomorrow will be another Memphis Musica Monday. Redbirds will be in their Memphis Musica uniforms. Meeting over, and Austin Warner going, oh, wait a minute, this is not how I planned it out in the bullpen. Yeah, that pitch counts up there already, 25, but again, only 11 strikes. And the Memphis bullpen slowly stirring in action. Cakes everywhere, O'Brien, Alvarez, and now Vigil. Here's the pitch, swinging a line drive to left field. Coming on is Ravello, and he has got it to retire the side. Again, they went after the first pitch. Took a little off the fastball, now to retire the side. The Cakes get two on back-to-back homers to start the game. They'll leave three more After half inning, New Orleans 2, the Redbirds coming up next on CW 30. This afternoon, the Redbirds will face New Orleans right-hander Cody Petit. He's 24 years old, and he's making his Triple-A debut at Double-A Jacksonville in the Southern League. 5-3 with a very nice 2.25 earned run average. His last time out was Sunday against Pensacola. Pick up a win. He went 7 scoreless, allowing one hit, walking one, striking out 11. As the Jumbo Shrimp beat the Blue Wahoos 7-1. And so they've got high hopes for this guy, don't they? And he's got a 2-0 lead before he even throws a pitch as New Orleans hit back-to-back homers to start the game today. Here's Randy Arozarena. He's 9 for his last 18. So let's see what this young right-hander has. Any nerves? That's a pretty good-looking pitch for ball one. Swinging on the 1-0 pitch and a lazy fly ball for Peter O'Brien. One up and one down. Now Max Schrock. Max hit 7th last night. He moves into the 2-hole. He did a lot of that last year. I'll put a shift on the right side for him. Ball one, he's hitting 238, no homers, 14 runs batted in. Yesterday, nothing for 4, as he'll take outside. The Redbirds losing 6-3, had 8 hits, as did the Baby Cakes. Cody Petit, P-O-T-E-E-T. Hides behind the glove for a moment, and a foul back. 2-1 the count, just said, here's a 91-mile-an-hour fastball. Let's see if he can hit it. He fouled it back. Two on pitch. That'll even the count. So he just comes right back with a couple of fastballs to even things up. Max awaits, and he chased the change. That's a pretty good one, 85. It's the first look at it for the Redbirds. Two gone. He's a fastball, curve, slider, changeup kind of guy. Sinks the fastball. Full trot completely there. Two gone. For John Nagowski. John, a couple of infield hits yesterday, extending his hitting streak to 14 games. And he'll take outside ball one, now hitting 309. 5 home runs, he's driven in 42. And the hitting streak is at 15. He hit it a little bit toward the end of the bat. Guerrero get it back in a hurry, and there you go. You get the streak thing out of the way in your first at bat, then you just play the game from there. No distractions. Although Rangel Ravelo had a 19-gamer earlier in the year, said he really didn't think about it. Here's Adolis. Always has those pretty blue shoes on Sundays when they break out the powder blues. 241 with a team best 15 homers and 52 runs batted in. One on after two are out. Swing and a miss. Chase went upstairs. When he's been on the bases, he's been very busy. By the way, he had a 10-game hitting streak end yesterday. Went 0 for 3 with a walk and a couple of strikeouts. Make it strike two. Very vocal plate umpire is Clayton Ham today. Winds are calm today at the ballpark, which means a little steamier for the folks who have come out today. Inside out swing off the screen and then pinballing into the seats. Late movement in on his hands and a late decision to try and spoil it, which he did. Petit is not listed in the top 30 prospects for the Marlins, which means absolutely nothing. He's had a terrific 3 months in the Southern League. 1-2. As long as they keep moving you along, you don't worry about it. You can earn your way into prospect status. If you're a starting pitcher and you're getting the ball every fifth day, that's all you can ask. Then it's up to you. 1-2. Fastball by him, and that'll do it. Couple of strikeouts for Petit, a single from Nagowski, and a runner left. At the end of an inning, it's 2-0 New Orleans as you watch the Redbirds on CW30. At the end of an inning, New Orleans leads 2-0, and a rude welcome back to the Pacific Coast League for Redbirds starting pitcher Austin Warner. John Barrett led off and hit his second pitch for a home run. Lewis Brinson followed and hit his fourth pitch for a home run. John Nagowski couldn't make a play on those. And here's the pitcher, Cody Petit, to lead it off as the Cakes sent 8 men to the plate in the first after 2 home runs and 2 outs. New Orleans would load the bases. Warner back to work, and he starts it with a strike, and that's how the game began. Then it turned south in a hurry for him. Working quickly. And it's 0-2. We like quick workers, don't we? Especially on a hot day. You got to keep the pitch count down, or this weather will sap you very early. Chased one in the dirt. It's a block. And he's going to jog the obligatory move, and that'll go 2-3 on the strikeout. And talking about emptying the tank early, Austin needed 26 pitches in that first inning. Watch this ball just bounce. Top of the order, and here is John Birdie to face Warner. Birdie hit the second pitch of the game. Out of here. Last night, 1-for-4 in RBI. Takes a strike, came out late in the game. He's rehabbing, so they got him out. National League rules, so you can't hide a rehabbing guy in the DH role. A one hopper for Schrock, who'll run it halfway to first. Take care of Birdie for the second out of the second inning. Max knew he had a lot of time. Wanted to get the feet just right, and obviously wanted to get the right grip on the baseball. And with two outs, here is Lewis Brinson, a no doubt about her. Last time. Hitting his 12th of the year, 46 RBIs. He's been with Miami. It didn't go well. Over from the Brewers last year. Went 15 of 76 with 28 strikeouts in 28 games for the Marlins back in April. There's strike one, a ball to strike. See, he's got the long arms and all that, so he's got leverage. He's got to get extended to do his damage. Austin's 1-1. Jammed him and popped him up. Nagowski right next to Lopez, and that's much better. That's a 1-2-3, 8-pitch inning for Austin Warner. Bottom of the second coming up. Redbirds trail New Orleans 2-0 as you follow Redbirds baseball on CW30. Rodrigo Vigil sends it down to second base after the warm-ups of his right-hander, Cody Petit. Yeah, hi, Mom. Whichever relative you prefer to call out. Oh, and they're going for the kiss cam. That's later, folks, but that's okay. Warm-ups are allowed. Memphis down 2-0 to New Orleans, bottom of the second inning, and Rangel Rivelo, the Redbirds all-star. He and Jake Whitford heading to El Paso in a little over a week. I guess a week from Wednesday will be the game. Good start for Petit, who struck out two, allowed one hit in the first inning. Big Jake will be the starting pitcher for the Pacific Coast League. Always hiding behind the glove is Petit. And that just misses a ball to strike. Outfield straight away. Rivelo will use the whole ballpark. Just if you pitch him away, it goes that way. You pitch him in, he'll yank it. 1-1. Did he go? The sinker missed, and it did not go for his strike as first base umpire Malachi Moore declines the appeal. 2-1. We had a late night last night. Start of the game delayed 57 minutes by rain, and then played a game of 3 hours and 11 minutes. Tried to go to right, and he sends it into the seats. And a quick turnaround with a day game today. Redbirds with their fifth straight loss last night. Iowa's fifth straight win have now fallen 14 games back. 2-2. And that's a little deeper down the right side. But still a foul ball nonetheless. Rivelo will be followed by Hudson and then Irving Lopez. Another 2-2 pitch. That's hit hard, slicing into the gap, but over to get it is Brinson. Ooh, a little lackadaisical knee-high basket catch. Thought it was going to slice a little bit more as Rivelo hit that ball on the schnoz. But Brinson showing some range in center field. Long loping strides. You know, those style of athletes look like they're not running hard, but they really are. It's just the running motion can fool you, those long strides. One gone for Joe Hudson. Hitting 218, 8 homers, 15 runs batted in. And he will take a strike. Had a couple of home runs in the series at Oklahoma City. Boy, all the positive vibes coming out of that series are gone. Birds won the last four games of that five-game series. One ball, one strike, and the Redbirds have come home and dropped five in a row to open the homestand. And now for the year, our 17 games under 500 at AutoZone Park. It's too nice a place to not win. To third, and lots of time for Birdie. And there are two outs here in the second inning with the Redbirds down two. So Cody Petit has retired five of the first 6 men he has faced here at the AAA level. And here comes the birthday boy for the Redbirds. Got to have a good day on your birthday, right? Joe Belamenez thinks so. That'll be Irving Lopez, 294. One homer, three RBIs. He is hitting four straight. One hit yesterday. A shift on for him as he looks at a strike. They put an infielder in right field. Two outs, bases clear. Birds down a couple. Going outside. And he's low over the outside corner. That's that sinking fastball coming in there at 93 miles an hour. Redbirds with one hit in the first inning from Nagowski. As Irving will take wide, 2-1. That was a two-out single. Twenty-six pitches early on for Poteet with 16 for strikes. Following behind Lopez, 2-1. Had a swing at a fastball away, 2-2. Cardinals, another loss in San Diego. Matt Carpenter was to be back in the lineup after a couple of days off, but he's under the weather and he has been scratched. They try and get Matt headed back in the right direction. Cardinals playing at 3:10 St. Louis time. Michaelis against Lucchesi. Here it's 2-0 New Orleans in the bottom of the second inning. Left that ball up and Irving fouled it back. Yeah, New Orleans is 8 games over .500, trailing San Antonio by 5, and they got to get by Round Rock first. They trail Round Rock by 2.5 games. Two balls, two strikes. And the birthday boy gives himself a present with a two-out single. Well, they had a two-out single in the first. Couldn't manufacture anything from there forward. Let's see what they can do here in the second. Just took it right back up the middle. It's so simple, it's cliche-ish, but it really does work. So Irving aboard with two outs, and that'll get the LSU product, Kramer Robertson, to the plate. Hitting .253, four homers, 18 RBIs. Just three hits in his last 19. Have been swinging it very well before that, but still driving runs during this little brief cool spell, four RBIs. There's a strike. Lopez bluffed at first like he wanted to go. He's yet to officially try and steal a base. So it's coming up from Springfield. Kramer Robertson, not a big guy, but he's got power. I mean, four home runs and the amount of time he's been here, that's a good number. And Poteet will chase Lopez back. Nothing in one, the count. There he goes, great jump. The pitch is in, the throw is a good one. He tagged him on the shoulder and he is called out. That was some kind of jump for Lopez. I don't know if we get another look at that one or not. Let's see. Well, from that angle, it'll look close from high home. It's a good throw, though, by Vigil. One hit, none left. We play two. Cakes two, Memphis nothing on CW30. One of the worst seats in the house, actually, that shot is in the dugout. It's hot. The benches are hard, and if you sit on the bench, you don't see very well because you're down below ground level. Now, if you're up here, this is what you see, and that's pretty sporty, don't you think? Third inning here at AutoZone Park. New Orleans leads the Redbirds 2-0, and Ehsan Diaz will start it off for the Cakes. And he'll take strike one from Austin Warner after giving up home runs to the first two batters of the game. Has settled down. He had a 1-2-3 second inning. A matter of the Redbirds' bats coming to life now. Now the good one. To left field, Ravelo would seem to think he has got room, and he does on the warning track, though it got awfully close to where it says FedEx in big letters. Diaz flirting with his 19th home run of the year. You can see Warner crane his neck saying, I hope not. One gone. Five in a row retired by Warner. And this is Austin Dean. got off to a great start this year for New Orleans, went to the big leagues, now having a solid year back in the PCL. So he takes inside. He was the Marlins minor league player of the year last year. Went after the first pitch in the opening inning and flew out to Arozarena in right field. And he's got himself a base hit. Is it going to be a single or a double? It's going to be a double as Ravelo has to play it off the wall. Stand up, one out double for Austin Dean. These guys aren't taking a lot of pitches, are they? Hit number four. They left the bases loaded, by the way, in the first inning following the two home runs. They picked up a single and a pair of walks with two outs. So Warner will look at trying to get himself a double play. Here's O'Brien. He singled in the first. Runner at second, one out. And he misses ball one. Only three double plays for Austin in his 15 outings this year. It's a hard way to try and get out of jams if he can't get a two-for-one deal. Took a little while to get his sign from Hudson. Now he's ready. Inside, 2-0. They really labored through the first inning, sailed through the second, and now is dealing with a runner in scoring position with one out on the third. They kick in the 2-0 change, misses high, and he's mad at himself, you could see. Well, they had another wild one in London today, the same outcome, though, the Yankees over the Red Sox. This one was 12-8. The Yankees got 9 in the seventh inning. 3-0, and he's swinging and missing, 3-1. Well, they played nearly 5 hours in a 9-inning game yesterday. We'll check the damage on the TOG. 4 hours, 24 minutes. Three-one pitch, strike two. He started to go and held up. Yankees only hit one home run in all that. Boston rallied for 4 in the 8th. The pull within 12-8. They actually out-hit the Yankees 15-13. He's battled back to a 3-2. And there'll be another one. This is a souvenir. Yeah, wildness over in London. Next year it's the Cardinals and the Cubs. Who's going? Who is going? Cubs are at Cincinnati today. Reds up 4-3 in the 8th. And there's another 3-2 foul ball. Had a lot of two-strike foul balls in last night's game. Suarez for the Reds, a home run that traveled 457 feet. 2-0 New Orleans, third inning. Trying to add to their lead. Austin Warner says, no, I don't want that. And taking a little more time. He's working very quickly the first two innings, especially the second inning. It's a liner, and that is a base hit. I don't think that'll score Dean. He had to break back towards second. He will stop at third. There's nobody to cut it off. And down to second base goes Brinson. And now Schrock and Nagowski look at one another across the diamond. Garcia's throw came in toward home, as you'll see here. And he threw it low enough to be cut off, but there was nobody home. And seeing that, O'Brien made his way in a second. So their runners at second and third and one out, and they'll talk about that when they get to the dugout. The manager will want to know what's up. And it looks like the Redbirds will draw the infield in here in the third. about halfway. Eddie Alvarez walked on four pitches his first time. And the fastball takes off high, ball one. So a mental error is somewhere. We have nowhere to point the blame. We don't do that up here anyway, but somebody was not where they needed to be. 1-0 pitch. Inside, not by much, 2-0 though. So Alvarez has seen six pitches, but he's not seen a strike yet today. The sun burning through the clouds behind AutoZone Park. That'll put the steam in you. Better have your sunblock on today, that's for sure. Cued foul, that was a good change. And you know, we spent a good part of our pregame interview with manager Ben Johnson today talking about spring training. First and foremost, before you leave the clubhouse, is the sunblock. If you don't put that on, man, it's not healthy for you. You spend 6 weeks down there to 2 months out in that sun. And then, of course, during the regular season, same deal. As you're out in the afternoon in the sun, batting practice and whatever early work you may be doing, better use it. You'll be sorry later on in life. 2-1 pitch. 3-1. On deck is Vigil, who walked his first time, and he walked to load the bases. Dean off third, O'Brien off second, Warner fires, and that's lifted down to left field line. Here comes Rivello, he will get it. Tagging from third is Dean coming home. And he will score without a tag. And the Cakes now lead Memphis 3-0. Ball was up where he could hammer it a little bit. RBI 10 for Eddie Alvarez. Nice little one-hop throw here from Ronel Rivello. But there's no way he's going to get Dean. There are now two outs. And here is Vigil, the catcher. He walked his first time. Now up to 51 pitches is Austin Warner. And a swing and a foul out of play. Tyler Heineman caught last night for the Cakes. Don't forget they also have Castillo available back from the big leagues. Looking to strand a runner in scoring position. Speared by Schrock at third. Boy, a rocket there, just like the first inning when they left them loaded. Herrera hit a line shot to Rivello in left. The Cakes will pick up a run. As you see, third base is just a reaction position there. You got time for a step, maybe. And he made the play. One run, two hits, one left. Middle of the third inning coming up. It's a three-run New Orleans lead on CW30. Getting ready for the bottom of the third inning. Redbirds trailing New Orleans 3-0 in game two of this five-game series. New Orleans winning the opener last night by a score of 6-3. Don't forget, our Independence Day celebration at AutoZone Park is on the third. 6:35 first pitch. Do not try and walk up to get a ticket. You need to go ahead and get them now. Go to memphisredbirds.com or come down to the box office tomorrow during the day and get those tickets, AutoZone, and those special Independence Day fireworks. Here's Kramer Robertson, the star of the Memphis half of the third, and he is aboard on one pitch. He was left at the plate in the second inning when Irving Lopez was caught stealing for the third out. So Kramer back on track with a leadoff single. We're going to see if Austin Warner can bunt the baseball a little bit. Then we get to go have an Independence Day celebration in Des Moines. If you're minor league baseball, you get both, certainly in the PCL. One team hosts on the third, then everybody travels to do it on the fourth in the other cities. Austin jabs at it, misses, 0-1. checks the signs from Ben Johnson down at third base. Down just three runs early on. And he missed it that one down away. That was a good location of the pitch, 0-2. See if he goes back upstairs and try and get him to pop it up or foul it off. That's Cody Poteet. And let's see, that's bunted hard down to second base. Bad throw, tag got him. Bad throw by Birdie. Great play by the shortstop, Alvarez, to make the decision to come off the bag and then an acrobatic tag play. Yep, right on there to make the call was J.J. January. So the Redbirds again issues with a sacrifice bunt. Warner aboard, one out, top of the order, and here's Arozarena. And now they're checking to make sure the bag is secured. You want it to be up just a little bit. You get some dirt forced underneath it. Then you can catch a toe under it and get hurt. So now the pitcher's got to stay out there on the bases in this heat and humidity. Not always a good thing. He'll take strike one. Redbirds trailed all night last night after New Orleans picked up four in the third inning. Pulled within 6-3 in the eighth with a pair of runs, and that was it. One on, one out for Memphis. Down three. Inside corner, 0-2. Rocky the Rockin' Red Bird on the chest of the Redbirds' powder blues. Not really holding Warner at first. That is low. Kind of in the neighborhood over there is Austin Dean playing at an angle in from first towards the mound, about two steps. Two adult steps. Or for me, three and a half. Poteet in his AAA debut here this afternoon. Tried to get on top of a high pitch and he'll get a base hit. Trying for a force at second base is Brinson. But Diaz was not on the bag. That ball was up and he somehow got on top of it. So I get the tying run to the plate. So you could see that was going to be a little close if there was a runner on the bag. Two on, one out for Schrock. Max struck out his first time. Seeing the background, the sign for the 2019 AAA National Championship game. It will be here. Redbirds played in the last two. Shift to the right side of the infield. And he hits it right into the shift, and that's going to go 6-3-4, the inning-ending double play. Max hit it hard, but hit it right into the teeth of the shift. And that's all there is to it. No runs, couple of hits, one left. We're through three innings in downtown Memphis, where it's the Baby Cakes 3 and the Redbirds nothing on CW30. Trying to find a way to stay cool and rested at a dugout. It's hard to do this time of year in downtown Memphis. Beautiful AutoZone Park on a Sunday afternoon. Trying to give the Redbirds a win. They've had trouble doing that the last month and a half or so. Right now the Redbirds trail New Orleans 3-0 as Rocky stirs it up in the background. Very dramatic. Emoting there with the kids. It's Rosel Herrera. Herrera line to left. First pitch swinging in the first. That left the bases loaded. He stung it, but Ravelo able to make the play. And he likes the first pitch again, and this is hit well, but not well enough. It'll take Arozarena to the warning track for the first out of the inning. So Herrera, good contact twice, but has had to go back to the dugout on both occasions. Here's Cody Petit, the pitcher. He struck out his first time. Give you the line through three innings after he fouls this out of play. New Orleans, 3 runs, 5 hits, no errors. Memphis, no runs, 4 hits, and no errors. The lefty, Austin Warner's pitch is hit to short, so Petit has to run somewhat. Robertson throws high, but Nagowski off the bag to make the tag. Kramer's had a few throwing problems the last couple of weeks. Boy, you can get bailed out with Nagowski over there. He's worth his weight in gold with that glove and his footwork. Two up and two down. And here is Birdie, who was homered and grounded to third. He homered to lead off the game, and then Brinson made it back-to-back. That's how the game began. Out of play, there's that first pitch attack of that fastball. That came at him at 90 miles an hour. Threw him the slider, fooled him. Did he go? No, definitely the pitch was good. It just missed, and Birdie did not commit to the swing. Just because you missed doesn't mean it's not a good pitch. Up high, 2-1. Two walks, 2 strikeouts for Austin so far today. And he's fallen behind. Birdie, 3-1 here in the fourth. Here's his 3-1. Didn't mean to, and he nearly picked off Brinson on deck. We've been talking about that during this homestand. His first Nashville and now New Orleans. Their guys have been getting awfully close to home plate. That nearly got Brinson. That can't end well. It just cannot end well if the foul ball hits you on deck. Happened in St. Louis a number of years ago, as you know. To left center field for Garcia. And a 1-2-3 inning for Austin Warner. So he's settling in a little bit. Unfortunately, Cody Petit's been settled in from the beginning for New Orleans. 3-0 Baby Cakes on CW30. See if that bird is that flexible there. It can go fly in all kinds of directions, can it? It'd be like an Osprey helicopter. Right now the Redbirds need to hit some fly balls out of the ballpark, trailing New Orleans 3-0. As we go to the bottom of the fourth inning, it'll start with John Nagowski. John lined a single to left in the first, extending his hitting streak to 15 games. Facing the righty, Cody Petit, just up from AA Jacksonville. John will look at his strike. Only two other day games in the Pacific Coast League, none other underway. Albuquerque at Sacramento just about to start. Salt Lake at Tacoma in about a half hour. Look out, that nearly clipped him, a fastball in. It'll be Nagowski, Garcia, and Ravello for the Redbirds. See how close it got? Yeah, you could feel it coming by. Little bag of your jersey, you'd be on first base. Petit's 1-1. Well, I thought for a minute there that Clayton Hamm was about to rise up, fire the right hand. He did not. It's 2-1. So, yeah, not a lot of scoreboard watching to do this afternoon in the PCL. We like to scoreboard watch. Duck in on the big leagues in a minute. 2-1. Evens the count. Cardinals are at, they're about to get underway. Royals lead at Toronto 6-7-6, bottom of the ninth inning. Cubs trailing at Cincinnati 5-3, bottom of the eighth. Phillies lead at Miami 12-6, eighth inning. Jotto slices this one to right, starting in and over, now drifting back. O'Brien's having trouble and will recover in time to make the catch. That ball just kept going. And it's not like there's a breeze blowing around here. Even the flag atop the Commonwealth building beyond left center is not moving at all. Well, O'Brien made the play, just never gave up with it. Here is Garcia, struck out his first time. Astros lead the Mariners 3-1 in the seventh. Pirates at Milwaukee 1-1 midway through. The first for Dolis is a strike. Twins at the White Sox, 2-0 Sox, sixth inning, they've got a rain delay. Dodgers lead at Colorado, 1-0 in the third. In the final, the Yankees winning in London over the Sox, 12-8. Reaching and sending a polite fly ball to center field is Garcia. A little bit of carry, but an easy dance back for Lewis Brinson, and there are two outs. Here's Ravello, line hard to center his first time. A couple other finals this afternoon. Cleveland won at Baltimore 2-0. Hard to get a shutout there. Texas lost at Tampa Bay 6-2. Nationals won at Detroit 2-1. There you go. You're up to date everywhere. Right here, it's 3-0 New Orleans in the bottom of the fourth inning. Ron Hell will take low ball one. Ron Hell comes in having hit in three in a row and four of his last five, but not as hot as he was before his big league promotion. You sit around for a while and you come back. It just takes you a little time to get back in that groove, and boy, was he in a groove before the call up. Strike one. Ron Hell in his third year here. Played at Nashville the previous season. And been a terrific pickup for the Cardinals. Is that fair? It is a fair ball. We almost had the ball boy go get it. He's trying to, spinning and throwing O'Brien, and he airmails everybody. That's a hustling double for Ravello. See, he hit that right off the very end of the bat, the pitch low and away. Brian did a good job of spinning and throwing. Shows his arm. The Redbirds getting a lot of their base runners with two outs in the first, second, and now fourth inning. The Birds have not been productive with two outs during this homestand. It's Joe Hudson's turn. He grounded a third. He is 0 for 1. Check swing, didn't mean to, and what a leaping snow cone catch by Austin Dean at first base. Really looked like an ice cream cone, half the ball hanging out of the webbing. That was going to be an excuse me RBI double for Hudson. Instead, a fabulous play by Austin Dean. You can see all that white in the end of the glove, but he held on to it just like an egg. For the Birds, no runs, they hit one left. We're going to the fifth inning. New Orleans 3, Memphis nothing. This is Redbirds Baseball at CW30. Austin Warner getting ready to work his fifth inning in his debut here in 2019. With the Redbirds, it's his 19th debut. He made seven starts here last year. So I would assume Mr. Warner has been issued some jewelry for his participation. The championship team a year ago. Lewis Brinson will start it. He is homered and popped to first. And he'll look at strike one inside corner. This is a guy with a lot of skills. He's had his struggles when given some opportunity at the major league level. Out in front of the curveball. And it's 0-2. Certainly has power. There are a lot of players, though, that have major league skills, but don't necessarily become long-term major league players. It's not that simple. The pitch was designed for up and in. It is, and Garcia, a little leap there. Concerned the ball might sail over his head. That ball was hit hard. It wasn't nearly as high as Hudson may have wanted. Brinson's showing you his strength when he gets those arms extended. One gone. 65 pitches for Austin Warner. We're in the fifth inning. So he's gotten it back into good shape after throwing 26 pitches in the first. He'll try Eason Diaz, who looks to strike. Diaz was hitting 299 coming in, threatening 300. He is 0 for 2. 18 homers, 52 RBIs. And that just missed outside the curveball. And the off-speed in, 2-1. Outfield straight away. And that ball is in a little bit, and it's right down the first base dugout steps. Two balls, two strikes. Keith Johnson, the manager this year for New Orleans, been in Salt Lake a good many years prior to this year. He's gone from the Angels to the Marlins. Target in, and it is inside. The kick in the 3-2, and it's just high. Austin thought maybe. Instead, that's his third walk of the day. He walked two in the first with two outs to load the bases. Diaz has two steals and five tries. And now here is Austin Dean. Double with one out in the third and would eventually score on a sacrifice fly. He's also flied out to right field. Might keep an eye on Diaz, even though he doesn't run that much. Curveball low. Looking for two. Redbirds' double play totals have gone down lately. Just a deliberate move to first. But a double play ball here would be nice, wouldn't it? That's not a double play ball. It's a fly ball into deep right center field for Arozarena. And there are two outs. As I look at the scorecard, there have only been two ground ball outs. Birdie to third in the second inning, and the pitcher Petit to short in the fourth. With these Major League Baseballs being used here in the PCL this year, being a fly ball pitcher may be hazardous to your pitching health. One on, two out. Here is O'Brien. He has a pair of singles, one in the first and one in the third inning. Warner will chase back Diaz. New Orleans with two runs in the first on the back-to-back homers and the Alvarez sack fly in the third. Runner goes, and he'll come back. It's fouled straight back. I just had a feeling Diaz would run this inning. Don't know why. I don't know that I have any logic or insight that would contribute to that. Just kind of had that feeling. And we'll see what they do with Diaz on the next. O'Brien awaits the 0-1. Sounded like a broken bat, and that ball's going out of the ballpark. Onto the bluff in left field. It sounded like a broken bat. Going to keep an eye on that bat as the bat boy takes it back in. That is a two-run homer and a 5-0 lead. Yeah, the players in the dugout are checking the bat for damage. That was a little toward the end of the bat. For O'Brien, his seventh, RBI 16 and 17. Third home run allowed by Warner today. And now the Redbirds are in a 5-0 hole here in the fifth inning. I don't think there's any doubt. Yeah, they're checking the dugout. He broke his bat. I don't know. They're looking at it. He's not sure. Sure sounded like it. Here's Alvarez. First pitch swing, and that's into left center field. Ravelo on the run will make the play to retire the side. Well, the Redbirds have given up some two-out damage this homestand as well. They get two on the O'Brien dinger. We're midway through here in downtown Memphis. It's now New Orleans 5, and the Redbirds nothing on CW30. Well, the work really cut out for the bunch in the powder blue unis today, housing that third base dugout. It is now 5-0. Cody Petit has a working lead in his AAA debut. He's looking like he's just hot. Could the weather be affecting him a little bit? 5-0 on three home runs for the Baby Cakes today. And Petit will face the bottom third of the Memphis lineup. Here's Irving Lopez, who singled in the second and was caught stealing. They'll put the shift on for Irving to the right side, putting one of the men in right field. And he'll take outside ball one. I wonder if O'Brien did break his bat. They were inspecting it in the dugout after he got back in there. It sure sounded like a broken bat. One ball, one strike. Irving thought it might have been a little wide. Looked like it could have been on the corner or just off a touch. Three home runs, accounting for four of New Orleans' five runs today. Outside of first. Mentioned Lopez is the birthday boy today. He is 24 today. Lives in Mesa, Arizona. Get traded to a team that has spring training out in Arizona. He could stay at home all spring. No small thing. 1-2 pitch. That's an ouchie. Ain't gonna stagger around. Well, we're overdue to see athletic trainer Dan Martin. He's been out so much this year. Redbirds with five hits, New Orleans with six. Irving in the hole, 1-2. That'll even things up. Despite the shift, I'm not trying to bunt against it during this homestand of the Redbirds. 3-2. I mean, after Robinson got those four bunt singles back in April, we haven't seen the Redbirds really test the shift. Now, they took it away from Drew. They would leave the third baseman over there to make it a much tougher bunt play. But for the rest of the fellas, it's out there. At first base, Austin Dean's right on top of the line and deep. Into the dugout. And into the front row on that foul ball. Yeah, I don't know how you can make helmets any cooler, though. They try it. But still plastic and foam enveloping your cabeza on the hot, sultry days. Count is run full, Petit fires. And he lost the ball four, and that'll be his first walk of the afternoon to go with one strikeout. Nice 8-pitch at bat for Irving Lopez, who reaches for the second time today. Kramer Robertson will try his hand. He led off the second with a base hit. Robertson has one steal. He's also been caught once. Out of play. The man at the plate. Lopez has not officially run. He's been on the move once, but I believe a foul ball involved. Kramer at the plate, though, as time goes by, I would expect to see him get a few stolen bases. He's got good speed. Haven't seen him utilize it in a bunting capacity. Good pickup by Vigil. One ball, one strike. I know I sound like a baseball dinosaur talking bunting when you don't bunt anymore. Certainly a lost start. Trying to get a base hit. It's becoming more of a lost start in the sacrifice realm, too, as we see time after time. People unable to get the bunt out effectively. One ball, one strike. Just inside. Only 62 pitches for Petit. So pitch count wise, he's in really terrific shape. Now, whether he's affected by the weather is a completely different matter. Fooled him at 84, and the count goes to 2-2 with the pitcher Warner waiting on deck. Like Brinson's being bothered by some gnats or something in center field. Keeps waving his glove to the side of his head. Two balls, two strikes. And that'll get away from V. Hill. That'll be a wild pitch. Now the Redbirds have had a few runners reach second base. They have not had one go as far as third base today. Kramer has worked the count full. Well, he walked Lopez 3-2. He's 3-2 here to Robertson. And that's down the left field line, and that's going to get the Redbirds on the board. Robertson with an RBI double, and it's a 5-1 game here in the fifth inning. Like he was out in front, fooled a little bit. RBI number 19. All right, there's a start. Let's see where this pitch was. They're going to bring the infield in. Warner tried to sacrifice last time and bunted right back to Petit, who got the force at second base. Redbirds with their second double. Unfortunately, New Orleans has three home runs in their extra base hit department. Squaring early, pushing at it, and fouling it back. I really want you to catch it with the barrel. Austin, a long look at Ben Johnson. I'm sure the sign doesn't change here. Austin's hitting 300 in his career at any level. Now the Birds on the board. It's a 5-1 game here in the fifth. Looking for more with nobody out. And that's 0-2. No 1-2-3 innings for Petit, although the Redbirds getting just their first run here in the fifth. Cake still looking bunt with two strikes. He will square early. And that'll be another failure to execute a sacrifice bunt for the Redbirds. That'll be the first out of the inning. And the second strikeout for Petit, sending the Birds back to the top of the order. And Randy Arozarena, he is 1-for-2. Find a way to get Robertson in from second base. Then you've made a little bit of progress. One run is nice, but two just sounds like a lot more, doesn't it? Rosarena's last home run, June 17th here against Las Vegas. Petit in a little more trouble. Quickly ahead, 0-1. I like Petit out there. Old-fashioned dirt on the fingers. Like you see hitters get a little dirt on the hands and spit onto the hands. That's how they used to do it back in the day. Nothing in one. That's a pretty good-looking pitch. One ball, one strike with Schrock on deck. Each team six hits, but the Cakes have hit three out of the ballpark. There's your game. And after a turnaround, everybody will back away. Trying to get a crooked number. Redbirds have been posting singletons lately. Good pick up there by Vigil. And it's 2-1. Yeah, nothing fancy from Cody Petit in his debut here this afternoon. You know, obviously the nerves would seem to be okay, just the one walk. Two strikeouts, kind of nondescript. Just efficiently getting through. Redbirds finally getting through to him for their first run here in the fifth inning. Joe Hudson trying to get out of the way of that one coming toward the Memphis dugout. Count even at 2-2. So, you know, we have bat boys and bat girls generally come out and get those baseballs and the bats and stuff, but would appear to be over 18, so does that mean that's Batman on the field today for the Redbirds? 2-2 pitch. Fought it off the last instant, decided to go after it. That'll be a souvenir as the ball's rolling back down the roof. It's rolling down the aisle. Who's going to get it? There you go. Robertson at second. He has driven in the Birds' first and only run of the game. Outside of third. Randy just trying to figure it out. He's been pretty steady in his 2 weeks plus here with the Redbirds. He's now hitting five in a row. His average at 343, and Cody Petit trying to figure out how to get him out of the way. With his 2-2 pitch. Playing back on it at third is Birdie. That's a long throw, and it gets past Dean and around third. Robertson, here he comes. The throw, the slide, he is safe as the call is. Robertson collides with the plate umpire, Clayton Ham. He's checking his right arm for damage. It was a bang-bang play at first. We'll have to wait to see if they scored a hit and an error. I would. Yep. An infield hit for Randy. Birds now within 5-2. Robertson scores on the E5. Down to second base goes Arozarena on the throw. And we have a meeting on the mound. Pitching coach Jeremy Powell is out there. Game's first error. So the Birds are within three with a run in scoring position and just the one out for Max Schrock, who has struck out, hit one sharply up the middle right into a 6-3 double play. Alvarez made the play. And they'll put that same shift. He's just to the right of second base and behind it some. Good curveball for his strike, 0-1. Some folks standing in the New Orleans bullpen, but nobody interested in getting ready to throw. Down to left field line, slicing, and that is just foul. Oh boy, that was close, wasn't it? 0-2 to Schrock. Yep. He was hopeful. So was I. I thought it was close. It was close. Just wide of the mark. So instead of an RBI double, Max has a count of 0-2. That's not very pleasant. Had a swing of the fastball. He got more of the plate than he wanted to, but at 93 it was enough. Schrock has played just third base since coming off the injured list this past week. Another 0-2, sinks it away. This is his highest pitch count inning. He's at 28 pitches for this fifth inning. He's been touched for a couple of runs, no coincidence. There goes Arozarena for third, the pitch high, the throw, the tag, and he is out. That's a big out. I will say this, the Redbirds have made a few outs at third base this year. Terrific throw by Vigil. And just like the other day, when he tried to go first and third, he dove way too soon. Two gone, and Schrock will hit one foul outside of first. Count stays at 2-2. And again, it doesn't, nobody does it really like Pete Rose used to. It really was a dive. These guys, it's a belly slide and you got your whole body taken up. The knees are like you're landing on an aircraft carrier, just digging in. Two balls, two strikes. Out of foul back, had a good swing at a fastball. Just those slides are too soon. The other day on the first to third, if he slides on timing, he is safe. And probably right here as well. It was much more clear the other day. And New Orleans about to get a pitcher busy, a right-hander. Two balls, two strikes. Out of play to our left. Nice little battling at bat. Padres get two in the first off Michaelis. They're up 2-0 at the end of an inning and a half. Machado with his 20th home run. He hit, what, two yesterday? Fastball away. This is a long trip for the Cardinals, taking them into the All-Star break. And off to a rough start in San Diego. As beautiful as San Diego may be, you don't enjoy it if you're not winning. 3-2. Just lost him. He started for the dugout, but Schrock instead will start for first base. Second walk of the inning, he walked Lopez to begin the inning, and Irving has scored. And now Rodrigo Vigil, the catcher, will go out and have a talk. Jordan Milbrath is up in the Cakes bullpen. Well, let's see if the two-out walk proves costly. Arozarena, unfortunately, made an out at third base. Garcia on deck. Birds have picked up two. They're looking for more with two outs. Outside ball one. Nagowski single in the first, fly to right, leading off the fourth inning. His hitting streak is alive and well at 15 straight. The average to 311 now. Oh, he started early, throw to first, and the ball is dropped by Dean. Schrock was dancing like he wanted to hit the ground running on that move home. Kind of a running start, and he nearly got picked. One-oh delivery. Now I'm going to try Max again. Well, the tags from Dean have been really about belt high, so you got the upper body plus the outreached arms back to the bag. Of course, this is how Ozuna got hurt the other day, breaking the middle and ring finger on his right hand. 1-0, too high. Thirty-six pitches in this inning for Poteet. He should be done. I mean, cooked. You have an inning like that in the middle of the game on a steamer like this one. 2-0. Big swing, and let's see if there's room over there for Austin Dean. He finds the wall, and the ball is two rows back, just enough. Well, the heat index at first pitch today was 100 degrees. We're going to get an update now at 3:44 in the afternoon. It's 99. It actually has gone down. I bet the fans and the players would not agree with that assessment. Still in this lengthy fifth inning, each team has scored twice. The 2-1 running is Schrock, and there's a base hit through the right side of the infield. And Schrock will go to third. And throw into second base, so Nagowski has himself a two-hit game, back-to-back multiple-hit games. That's now eight during this 15-game hitting streak. Well, if not for the out at third base, the Redbirds would have picked up a run right there. Redbirds have been caught stealing twice today by Vigil. And that is going to be all for Cody Poteet. Yeah, 89 pitches now, which is 38 in this inning. So he will leave. Probably lost 10 or 12 pounds. He'll get it all back in the clubhouse shortly. So we're going to have a pitching change here at AutoZone Park. We are in the fifth inning. The Redbirds have pulled within 5-2. We are back with more baseball at CW30 after this. There you see the numbers on the new New Orleans pitcher, Jordan Milbrath. It's his 13th outing of the year, a record of 0-1 with a save and a 6.23 Earned run average, 21 and two-thirds innings, six homers, that stands out. Eight walks, 28 strikeouts, they stand out. And he is on relief of Cody Petit here in the fifth. Petit couldn't stick around long enough to qualify for the win. 38 pitches here in the fifth inning, his undoing. Although there's also been a throwing error in the mix. Well, the first man that Milbrath will face is the Redbirds center fielder, Adolis Garcia. Adolis has struck out and fly to center. First and third, two outs, two are in. Memphis is pulled within 5-2. And it's a slider away, ball one. Redbirds have they have three hits in the inning, but they've drawn a couple of walks. There's been a wild pitch, there's been an error. There's also been a caught stealing in the middle of the inning as well. That looms large right now. Had him reaching, and there is room, it would seem, for Dean. And that'll do it. And Garcia is crouching down in the batter's box, upset. He knew he was in a big spot. Well, the Birds are on the board, and that's a start anyway. They get a couple of runs, and they'll leave two. That's five on the day. Five completed AutoZone. It's the Redbirds trailing New Orleans 5-2 on CW30. Redbirds back within three runs, trailing New Orleans 5-2 as we go to the top of the sixth inning here at AutoZone. They didn't pay to get in, but they're checking out the game anyway. Steve Selby with you from the third floor at AutoZone Park. A beautiful facility it is. So Austin Warner will try and get in a sixth inning for the Redbirds. He's at 76 pitches so far, 46 for strikes. He'll face Rodrigo Vigil, who held up on the swing. Vigil's earned his keep behind the plate. He's gunned down a base runner at second and one at third base. Little waiting game going on at the plate. That's a strike inside corner, 1-1. Cardinals still trailing at San Diego, 2-0. They've now gone to the third inning. Too low, 2-1, and plate umpire Clayton Hamm didn't like that one. That ball is done. Vigil is spelled V-I-G-I-L, like vigil. Only Vigil. 2-1. Up high. One more trip back in here for New Orleans. And that'll be the last time we see the baby cakes forever. 3-1. Big blast into center field. Too much air under it. Garcia goes back on its side straddle like Harrison Bader does. And there's one out. Yeah, the baby cakes are moving to Wichita, and they will no longer be the baby cakes, we assume. It's Rosel Herrera. He is line to left, fly to right. He has seen all of two pitches. One per at bat. There's a strike. Herrera and then the pitcher spot. That's high, 1-1. Chris Ellis is up in the Memphis bullpen. Did he go? That one I might appeal, they're not. Two balls and a strike. Warner delivers 2-1 at 81 miles an hour. It's hit for strike two. Sound like an explosion out in the distance. Wow. Had a foul to the Memphis dugout. Keeping it at 2-2. Bill Brath, the relief pitcher, waits on deck. And he'll foul another one off. Nice little at bat here for Rosel Herrera. Day like this one, the pace will slow and slow and slow. 2-2. That'll get foul and land off the sidewall, but not high enough for Arozarena to come over and make a play. He never got started for it. Three pitches spoiled by Herrera here. The flag's moving for the first time, but not doing much of anything. There's a pop to the shallow right field region. Lopez backpedaling. And there are two outs. And now we'll see Milbrath spin, swing the bat.
Now batting number 36, Jordan Milbrath.
We're in the sixth. It's a 5-2 New Orleans lead. Milbrath is 0-2 on the year. And he'll take ball one. Always hopes of getting a base hit if you're a pitcher. Got almost a smile on his face. Ball to strike. I think just his natural expression. See that Juan Marichal, the Hall of Fame pitcher for the Giants. Looked like he was smiling at the hitter all the time. Swing and a miss. Might be because he was going to strike him out. That wild, big, straight-up leg kick of his. Got in a little time with the Red Sox, I believe, at the end of his career. Scooted off the dish, and that strike three called. So a nice inning for Warner. If that's it for him today, it's a good finish. We'll depart for the bottom of the sixth inning. It's New Orleans leading the Redbirds 5-2 on CW30. Oh, there you see the score on the screen. It's 5-2 New Orleans trying to make it two wins in a row to start this five-game series. The loss today would be a Redbirds sixth consecutive defeat. Would just assume not experience that. The Reds found themselves down 5-0 at the end of 4.5. Did get two runs back in the fifth inning. Ronel Ravelo will try and stir it up to start this sixth inning. Final line for the New Orleans starter, Cody Petit, 4 2/3 innings. 8 hits, 2 runs. They were earned. He walked 2 and struck out 2, but did not get that final out to give him a shot at a win at his AAA debut. Milbrath getting ready, made the final out of the top of the inning, so he's just now getting ready to go. .66/.215, he is 27 out of Windham, Minnesota. Last year at Akron and Columbus. So in a new organization in 2019. He'll face Ravelo, Hudson, and Lopez, and here's the first of the trio. Ronel doubled in the fourth. He's also lined to center, so he swung it pretty good against Petit. As you would say, Petit scattered 8 hits in his 4 2/3 innings, the old terminology. Down a 3 spot, Redbirds have out-hit New Orleans 8-6, not enough. There's a strike. Milbrath came on in the fifth with runners at first and third, 2 outs, and got Garcia to foul to the first baseman, Austin Dean, over by the dugout. Nothing in one. High kind of brings it from the side somewhat, doesn't he? Baby Cakes having a solid season. They've had great pitching. A couple of starters have gone to the big leagues. If they stayed here, New Orleans might be leading their division. Reached and pulled it weakly to short for Alvarez, and there's one out. Yeah, generally a pitch away, he'll go with it, but he got fooled. Milbrath gets the leadoff hitter here in the sixth inning. So Ravello to the dugout and Hudson to the plate. Joe has grounded a third and popped up to Austin Dean, who made a great play. Leaping to his left, the ball nearly came out of the mitt. It's a little floater towards first base. Fastball high as Ellis is back up in the Memphis bullpen. To second. And Diaz to first. It's five pitches, two outs. McGrath getting the ground balls. We're talking about Warner not getting many ground balls this afternoon. Milbrath hadn't had a ball leave the infield yet. Two away for Irving Lopez, who's reached safely twice. He has singled, walked, and scored. He has also been caught stealing. The shift on for Irving. They do keep Birdie, the third baseman, close enough. It'd have to be a great bunt for a base hit. Fastball a strike. But you know what? As deep as Dean's playing at first, and with the second baseman Diaz in the outfield, a drag bunt past the mound is a good play, too. It's an easy play. Nothing in one. That's in the dirt. .635 tomorrow night, game three, the middle game of this series. Harold Alaruz versus Joe Gunkel. Two outs, nobody on. And that's foul outside of first. Dean says, I can get there, though. Bottom of the third in San Diego. Cardinals down 2-0 to the Padres. Cardinals three hits through three innings. Martinez has one, Munoz one, Michaelis has one. Edmund is playing second base today and leading off. Munoz is at third base. Munoz came off the bench for a hit yesterday. That's another hit for the birthday boy. He's celebrating, need to celebrate with a win. He is thinking too, and a good decision to go back. Here's the throw, and they nearly threw it to the dugout. A good save by Austin Dean. Two for two with a walk for Irving Lopez. He's got that timing device with that stride, doesn't he? Really nice job by O'Brien. He has a terrific arm. Another two-out hit for the Redbirds. Unfortunately, they're not getting two-out hits with runners in scoring position. Lopez with the arms dangling there as he takes the lead, and Kramer will take a strike. He singled in the third, and he doubled in a run in the fifth and also scored. Kramer Robertson, his homestand has played a good bit of third base, but he's at shortstop today with Sosa out of the lineup. He's been getting a lot of playing time and getting his share of hits. Held up, it's 0-2. Ellis continues in the Memphis bullpen. Milbrath readies for his 0-2. way outside, and a backhand stop by Vigil sent the mask flying. Kramer Robertson, if you don't know the story, his mom is the head basketball coach of Baylor's women's team. Oh, by the way, happened to have won the national championship this year. Yeah. One ball, two strikes. Outside and low. Baylor won a couple of championships, I think. Connecticut's had a couple tough times the last few years closing things out. 2-2. That's a wild one. And that'll send Lopez in the scoring position with two outs. That's what happened in the fifth inning. This wild one is for Milbrath, the other Petit. See if we can steal the two-out run here and get within two. It's a 5-2 New Orleans lead here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Browns crew on standby in the dugout. The count is full as Robertson awaits. Outside of third. Lopez runs well at second base, two outs. He's got a score on a base hit. The outfield's back a little bit straight away. And there's a gapper, and that'll get the run in, and the ball will go all the way to the Redbirds bullpen. Robertson stops at second with his second two-base hit of the afternoon, and the Birds are 60% back. They trailed 5-0. It's 5-3 here in the sixth inning. RBI 20. It's a terrific at bat, working the count full as he did last inning. Yes, the Robertson we've been seeing for a few weeks. Here is Justin Williams, just up from AA Springfield. He's been out all year with injuries. You may recall the Redbirds got him in the Tommy Pham deal late last year. He never really was healthy in August end of the postseason. He's got a chance to make some friends here. Justin was Springfield in 17 games, was hitting 193 with a homer, three RBIs. He'll put a shift onto the right side as he bats left and takes outside. At Springfield, Justin had 57 at-bats, walked four times, struck out 17 times. Redbirds now with three doubles. They need that first home run. Fastball away for a strike. 1-1. Justin, 6'1", 215. He is only 23. And I'm not remembering the pronunciation, the town of Louisiana, Houma. Maybe H-O-U-M-A, Louisiana. One ball, one strike. Swing and a miss. High fastball. I do know when we played in New Orleans after the trade, the media came out in substantial numbers. It was a story that he was coming home to play. He's got the long white sleeve on. He's had some random injuries. I think he broke his hand in the offseason. One ball, two strikes. And that's popped up. The shallow left, you got three men in pursuit, and it is going to be the shortstop Alvarez, who came from the right side of second to track it down. And that will retire the side. But the Birds draw a little bit closer, a run, two hits, and one left. We've completed six. The grounds crew's doing its thing. It's the Redbirds trailing New Orleans 5-3. right here on CW30. Well, the Redbirds trying to make a game out of this thing. Trailing New Orleans by a score of 5-3, and they'll go to the bullpen here on his right-hander Chris Ellis taking over for Austin Warner, who gave the Redbirds six innings today. For the tall right-hander, this is appearance 25, a record of 2-3 with one save and an earned run average of 7.12. There you see his stats on the screen. Chris's last outing coming on the 27th. He took a loss against Nashville, one inning, one hit, two runs, and a couple of walks. Through six innings, five runs, six hits, one error for the Cakes. As Joe Birdie takes a ball, Memphis three runs, 10 hits, and no errors. Birdie is homered in three tries today. Pretty good look at pitch. Ellis thought so, 2-0 though. Austin Warner's six innings, six hits, five runs, three walks, three strikeouts. 2-0, that's a strike. Parker Bug is up in their bullpen. And that's hammered to left field, chasing Ravelo back, and that ball is gone. It ricochets off the wrought iron up onto the bluff. That is home run number four this afternoon for New Orleans, number two for Birdie. And they get a run back and lead the Redbirds 6-3. I think tell the Marlins he's ready. Get him out of here. Wow, 362 feet on that. A root greeting for Ellis. You had a couple home runs in a day. You're feeling pretty good going around the bases. A little more of a bounce in your step, don't you think? Now here's Brinson. He is homered. 1-for-3 lined hard to center field last time, looking at a strike. Well, it's getting to the back third of the game. There's a strike. If you're looking to come from behind, you can't keep letting New Orleans answer back. Six-three, that was the final last night. New Orleans winning game one of the series. Shattered his bat, and it's popped to short. In comes Robertson. That ball's at bats at a couple of pieces to the right of home plate. And there's one gone, a bounce back at bat there for Chris. Yeah, Schrock's got him a filthy uniform, doesn't he? One away for the lefty, Eson Diaz, who's nothing for two with a walk and a run scored. Now he snapped the bat over his leg, heading the first base. Well, he cheated, it was already broken. Check swing foul. That'll be a strike, quick 0-2. I mentioned earlier Machado with his 20th for San Diego. He's got 56 RBIs. I mean, they're paying crazy money, but he's having a good year. That's a bouncer off Hudson. Philadelphia not feeling like they got their return on Bryce Harper yet. Machado getting the job done. Teams are surprised it was San Diego went after him. To short on a hop for Robertson. Two away. Two gone, and that'll get Austin Dean to the plate. Dean doubled and scored back in the third inning. He is one out of three as Ellis gathers himself. Seeing the background, that's Tony Cruz, the former Memphis and St. Louis catcher, now working in the Cardinals organization. Tony is a roving pitching instructor or coordinator, or catching instructor or coordinator. It's his second trip in this year. A ball and a strike. Tony had him a nice little career. 1-1. That's up the roof. Coming back. Yes, it is. Here we go. That youngster's going to get a souvenir. 2 outs, nobody on, a run in on the birdie leadoff homer. Didn't chase the breaking ball, 2-2. O'Brien would be next, and he's only 3-for-3 with a homer. Back-to-back homers, birdie and Brinson in the first. Two-run homer O'Brien in the fifth, and a leadoff homer from John Birdie here in the seventh. 4 big flies. 2-2. He'll get another. Fifth inning now in San Diego, 2-0 Pods. 2-2, and he'll try it again. Here in Memphis, it's New Orleans 6 and the Redbirds 3, inning number 7. On the hands line right to Robertson, never had to move an inch. Well, he gets the next 3 to Zelis, but Birdie starts it off with his second home run of the day and his 4th of this rehab assignment. Stretch time here at AutoZone Park. It's New Orleans 6 and Memphis 3. New pitcher for New Orleans as we've reached the bottom of the 7th inning in downtown Memphis. And for the Baby Cakes, it'll be right-hander Parker Bug. That's with 2 G's. Goes 6'6", 210 pounds. Large fellow. He is 24. Lives in San Diego. He's got a tough life, doesn't he? And here are his numbers. In 10 outings with the Cakes, he is 0-2 with a save. Earned run average of 7.98. 14 2/3, 16 hits, 5 of them homers, walking 8. And striking out 20 is on for Jordan Milbrath, who went an inning and a third today with 2 hits, 1 run, no walks, and no strikeouts. He did, however, strand a couple of runners in the 5th inning, which looms large in this 3-run game. As Birdie hits a second home run in the top of the 7th inning to extend the New Orleans lead back to 3 runs, 6-3 Cakes. And for the Redbirds, it'll be the top of the order, Randy Arozarena. It's a tall right-hander, isn't he? Center field camera doesn't do his height justice. Randy steps out as the pitch is delivered a strike. 2 out of 3 for Randy, an infield hit in the 5th. His last time up. It's got a great up on us, hadn't it? Fastball to strike. There's some stuff to the south that's not supposed to get here. Steered one just outside, almost like he's not throwing a dart. It's not that kind of motion, but he's trying to be that precise, it looks like, on his release. Very deliberate in his release, I guess. He's ahead of Randy, 1-2. Laced through the left side, a base hit. Well, the Redbirds not lacking for hits. They've got 11 of them today. Randy's got 3 of them. Well, Randy came in hitting 338. These 3 hits not hurting him either. Thigh-high fastball into left field. Good start to the Memphis 7th inning. And here is Max Schrock. He is 0-for-2. He drew a walk in the 5th inning. Redbirds drew two walks that inning. Scoring 1, Lopez, who led off the inning with a free one. New Orleans leads the season series 3-2. They split 4 back at the Shrine on Airline in late April, beginning of May. Outside, and they continue to put 3 men on the right side. But with a runner at first base, they don't put the second baseman Diaz in the outfield. He plays in the infield, basically midway between first and second, and he is deep. Fouled straight back this way. That's what the screen's for. It was coming in this direction. I think it was going to have too much topspin to make the window. Comes up short. That's the one that's right in front of the ledge where if you stick your hand down, you get your fingers mashed against the cement. Cement, as they say, is the cement pond of the Beverly Hillbillies. 1-1. And now it's 1-2. Yeah, 11 hits for the Redbirds. 3 doubles. No homers, only 1 double producing a run. 1-2. That may have been a little high, wasn't taking any chances though, so Max will live to face at least one more. Outfield toward left. I'll say this, Brinson plays a little deep. He's the center fielder. Fouling off another high with 91. Bug joined the Baby Cates on the 27th of May. Made his debut the next day against Iowa and gave up a couple of homers. Yep. Christening isn't always pretty, is it? And that's just outside. 2-2. Bug has been scored on in his last 3 outings, a combined 5 1/3 innings, 9 hits, 8 runs, all earned, 5 walks. So he's had some struggles with the Cakes. And his touch for a leadoff hitter, hit by Arozarena. That ball's in the air deep into left center field, and that ball is into the basket, and that'll be a ground rule double. That's a break for New Orleans for the time being. Got the cutout window with a mesh for the Redbirds bullpen bench, and it goes off the mesh and then can get lodged between the mesh and the padding. So Max delivers the Redbirds' 4th double of the afternoon. And that will get the tying run of the plate. And it's John Nagowski, who's already 2 out of 3 today. And we need that first big fly, and he is due. Despite all the hitting and all the doubles, the home runs have not been coming. New Orleans will play the infield back with a 3-run lead and nobody out. Strike 1 called. And he jumps up and down in the box. Oh, the agony. Last home run, June 7th at Reno. Wow, it's already been over 3 weeks since we're in Reno. This season really is flying by. They all do, even though it feels like a grind while you're in the middle of it. And they really do. From the stretch. And that's into the gap in left center field, heading for the bullpen, and it's going to bounce into the pen. Ground rule double scores 2, and the Birds are winning 6-5 on Nagowski's 3rd hit of the afternoon. RBI's 43 and 44, so the first ground rule double does not prove costly. That was a slider that stayed up. Now Garcia, he's a quiet 0-for-3, came in having hit safely in 10 of his last 11, and New Orleans is not getting anybody up in the bullpen. Birds within 6-5, now with 13 base hits. Still nobody out. At the knees, 0-1. Nagowski's double, his 17th. He and Rivelo battling it out for the team lead, but Ron Hill had one in the fourth inning, so he has 18. Love doubles. Good save there by V. Hill. One ball, one strike. Gowski representing the tying run, inches off second base. Outside corner, and it's 1-2 to Garcia. Folks out on the balconies throughout Fielder Square Apartments in right and right center field today. Pretty cool deal to sit out and watch a game. Fastball too high, 2-2. Sure, the fireworks sometimes at 10 or 11 o'clock at night may be an issue for the early to betters, but sit out there and watch. It's like sitting across from Busch Stadium at Ballpark Village, right? Sometimes there are folks up on the YMCA, up on the Fogelman Building. Two balls, two strikes. And he's not getting cheated, is he? There's no cutting down on the swing for Garcia. Never has, probably never will, although if he does learn to do that, it will go a long way in trying to get him to the big leagues and keeping him there. Speaking of Rivelo, he waits on deck. And another foul, that went off him. Checks the end of the bat to see if it's damaged. Well, do the Marlins have another yard sale at the end of the season at the trade deadline? Remember, July 31 is hard. There's not that loophole. Waiver wire deals later on. I'm sure they'll find another loophole in the rules somewhere. What do you think? What do the Cardinals do? They go get help? Do they stand pat? Or do they sell some players off and buy some prospects? Bug will try it again. And fans get excited. That doesn't have the distance. Brinson is there. Nagowski will bluff but not go. And that'll be the first out of the inning as Bug's afternoon began single, double, two-run double. It's a big out confidence-wise for Bug. Here is Rivelo. He has doubled in three at-bats. That'll bring about a visit to the mound from the catcher, Rodrigo Vigil. And right on the heels of that, pitching coach Jeremy Powell will make his way out there. Got Ben Johnson halfway towards home. He's got his lineup card and his note sheet out that he's taking a look at. We can get a look at that, guys. And now he'll talk with John Nagowski. Ben's always got some paperwork in his hands. There he is. Just, you know, there's less than two outs. Don't run yourself into an out. Certainly don't get picked off. And I'll play it umpire Clayton Hams decided that's long enough, too. There's Ben. You see he's got the pen out, got the paperwork, got the stopwatch working. And, of course, on a hot, humid day, it's always time to wear a plastic batting practice jacket, which is what a lot of staffers do these days. Sweat some bullets. You look in the Redbirds dugout. Pitching coach Nero Roscoe's got the same thing going, too. Standard stuff. Well, all right, it's time for They're putting Ravello on. And here's Hudson. As they set up the double play, they're putting the go-ahead run on first base. Two on, one out. And that's in the dirt, and a terrific stop by Vigil there. Joe hit into a double play two nights ago. He's had a tough homestand. Had a good series at Oklahoma City with a pair of homers. Today, two ground balls and a pop fly. Overall against New Orleans, he is 3 out of 8. He had a 3-for-5 outing in New Orleans early in the year. And a drive to right field, chasing O'Brien back. He is out of room, and it is off the wall. One run is in. Ravello is waved around third. Here he comes. Here's the throw. He is safe, and the Redbirds have the lead here in the seventh inning. Ending up at third base is Hudson. 7-6 Redbirds. I would assume they will rule that a double. How close would that come to getting out of here? Could tell up against that white sign, the waste management sign. A 4-run seventh for the Redbirds. Ravello got caught up. He wasn't sure if the ball was caught or not, but he would score. Two RBIs for Hudson, 16-7. New Orleans brings the infield in for Lopez, who is 2 out of 2 with a walk. Still no action in the New Orleans bullpen. Jammed and fouled out of play. Make an even better birthday if he gets the run in here. Anyway, he can get the run in. Swing here. Fly ball right. O'Brien has it. Here comes Hudson. Here comes the throw, and it is not in time. In safely on his belly is Hudson. The birthday boy does drive in a run, and the lead grows to 8-6. What a nice day for Lopez. 2-for-2, a walk, and now an RBI. Redbirds don't hit a lot of sacrifice flies. Eight-six Birds. Here's Robertson, who is 3-for-3 with 2 run scoring doubles to his credit. And that pitch is up high. There's a strike. Robertson, a big slash down the right side, and that will land harmlessly on the grass. Edmundo Sosa is out on deck. 1-ball, 2-strikes to Kramer. That's high. Two balls, two strikes. To right field for O'Brien. And this lengthy inning for Parker Bug finally comes to its conclusion, as the Redbirds pick up a 5 spot on 4 hits. And we'll go to the eighth inning with Memphis now leading it by a score of 8-6. Well, we've got ourselves a brand new ball game here at AutoZone Park, do we not? The Redbirds have trailed 5-0 and 6-3. And a five spot in the seventh inning has Memphis with their first lead in a couple of days. It is 8-6 as New Orleans bats in the eighth inning. Peter O'Brien starts it off. He is 3-for-3 with two singles and a two-run home run. Taking a strike, his home run up onto the grass in left field in the fifth inning. Sounded like he broke his bat. They were checking it out after he got back in the dugout. I'm not sure if they found any damage or not. Nothing and one from Chris Ellis, and he's quickly ahead 0-2. Trying to snap a five-game losing streak. And he locked him up, and O'Brien knew it. He's gone for the first time. Good pitch from Ellis, who gave up a home run to John Birdie, the first man he faced last inning, but now has retired four straight. Look at this pitch. Just locked him up. Nothing you can do about it. Just go sit down. San Diego has padded the lead on a Hosmer base hit in the fifth inning. 3-0 Padres as the Cardinals get ready to bat in the sixth. This is the switch hitting Eddie Alvarez, taking just a touch high ball one. He has walked, driven in a run with a sack fly to left and fly to left a second time. Strike one. Little bit of breeze now. Just gets my attention a little bit. 1-1. Swing and a miss. You know it can materialize out of nowhere here in the Mid-South. Yesterday there was 0% chance of rain. I mean zero. And we had that deluge right before the game caused a 57-minute rain delay before we finally get started. 1-2. Foul tip held onto by Hudson. Good fastball, 95 down by Ellis. Two KOs here to start the eighth inning. Yeah, and a little bit of run away from the lefty and the grimace from Alvarez. Was hopeful that Hudson had not held on, thinking he had foul tipped it. Two away for Vigil. He has walked line to third, a shot in the third right at Schrock. And he's flying to center, and he's quickly behind 0-1. Ellis is feeling it right now, just smoked 95 right in there again. He's pumping in a lot of strikes. Nine pitches this inning. Eight for strikes. Oh, he just missed with a slider. Boy. Vigil couldn't have pulled the trigger there either, could he? Chris is getting it and throwing it. He is feeling it. His 1-2 pitch. Had him on the front foot. It's not a strikeout, but an easy play for Arozarena. And Ellis and the Birds get the shutdown inning, sending us to the bottom of the eighth inning. It's still Memphis 8, New Orleans 6, as you follow the Redbirds on CW30. Well, the Redbirds are taking a lead into the bottom of the eighth inning, hopeful of adding to it perhaps 8-6. Defensive change for the Baby Cakes. Sierra is going in to play left field. Let's see if Herrera has come in to play third. Herrera's at third. And here is Edmundo Sosa is off the bench to pinch hit. The lead is two. The Memphis bullpen is busy as Sosa stands in, hitting 271 with eight homers, 26 runs batted in. He'll take a fastball high from Parker Bug, who gave up the five runs in the seventh. Started with an Arozarena leadoff single. One ball, one strike. So last night, nothing for two. He got hit twice. Ball to strike inside. He nearly turned into getting hit again. Maybe he was trying to. 2-1. He's hit safely in 8 of 9. That's an in-between hop. What a play. Spinning Alvarez throws low, and it gets past Dean. Fortunately for the Cakes, it did not go into the dugout. And let's see if that's not an infield hit for Sosa. A great stop by Alvarez. Oh, that's a tough error. You dive to your left, you get up, spin, and rush the throw. That is a very difficult error. Yes, if the throw's on the money, it's accurate, but it's not like a routine one-hopper to the shortstop. Top of the order for Arozarena, who is 3 of 4, taking high for a ball. Hey, you wouldn't mind adding on another run or two or three, would you? Randy awaits, and that's belted to right field. O'Brien is back, and that is gone. Arozarena goes opposite field. There's a couple of runs, and a 10-6 Redbirds lead here in the eighth inning. They're serious about snapping this skid, aren't they? And the woes continue for Parker Bugs this afternoon. Home run. Number 3, RBIs 10 and 11, and it's a four-hit game for Arozarena. Redbirds finally get one out of the yard. 10-6 Birds. And Schrock will look at his strike. He doubled in the madness last inning, 1-for-3 with a walk on the day. See if maybe that Sosa play is not changed after the game. This is hit into the shift. Backhand play, Diaz, nicely done for the first out of the inning. Well, Schrock retired for the first out of the eighth. That here is John Nagowski, who is now 3 out of 4 today, including a 2-run double in the seventh. His hitting streak has reached 15. His batting average has reached 317. He'll take ball one, showing the stripes as he always does. That is Chris Beck in the Memphis bullpen. Late foul outside of third. Kyle Keller is up for New Orleans. Up to 39 pitches already for Parker Bug in an inning and a third. That's a big number. Birds now with 10 runs on 15 base hits. Two and one. Birds pouring it on, 2 in the 5th, 1 of the 6th, 5 in the 7th, 2 so far here in the 8th, 2-2. Anyway, that ball's been flying to right field. The wind's not blowing today. The flag's barely moving in center now. It hadn't for the most part at all. But it's been carrying out there. O'Brien's been forced to race to the wall several times, and here comes another one to right field, but not quite as deep. O'Brien likes to slap the left thigh with his glove when he has it in range. And there are now two outs. It'll be a 3-for-5 day for John Nagowski. Yeah, we've talked about it, some of the Redbirds pitchers and all pitchers, really. You get into an inning, as you're watching Bug there a moment ago, and you just can't seem to get out of it. Just keep snowballing. Here's Adolis. He is nothing for 4. And he's about to be 0-for-5. That's not going to have quite enough carry. That is Brentson, and that will retire the side. Two big runs there, absolutely, give you some breathing room. Last call for the Baby Cakes. We're headed to the ninth inning. It's Memphis 10 and New Orleans 6. Chris Beck to the hill for the Redbirds. We made our way to the ninth inning on a humid and now cloudy Sunday afternoon at AutoZone Park for the right-hander. This is appearance 29. He is 0-5 with a 6.47 ERA, but he's been perfect in save chances, 5 out of 5. However, this is not a save chance with that two-run homer from Arozarena. The Redbirds' lead has grown to 10-6, so he's just on to just make quick work. Shake some hands after lining up, and then start thinking about tomorrow and maybe a second win in a row. This game started with New Orleans hitting back-to-back home runs. Birdie and Brinson did that. Rosel Herrera to lead it off. He's line to left, fly to right, pop the second. He's a switch hitter, batting left here. Beck works out of the stretch. Big, strong right-hander. It gets quickly ahead 0-1 with 95 in the zone. A big day with the bats for the Redbirds today. 1-1. 7 hits for the Cakes while the Redbirds have banged out 15. Solarte on deck to pinch hit. And now Chris will step off and right back on. And that's Jan Hervis Solarte. Been around this league a little bit. One ball, one strike from Beck. Sharply to second. Lopez makes it look routine, and there's one out. And here comes Solarte, his first appearance in the series. He's a switch hitter who is batting 320 with 1 homer and 9 runs batted in. Played last year for Toronto. Now 31 out of Venezuela. One out and 2 more to go. Fouled up this way. That was hit to my left-hand side, no chance. Nothing in one, and a cue shot to the Redbirds dugout, nearly picked off our Batman. And it's 0-2, there's a hole somewhere from where that ball hit. Oh, there it is. It's a good thing I moved. Nothing in two. Towards first, and that'll get foul. Nagowski fields it in foul territory. Yeah, it wasn't like that polite when we were talking about in the first couple of innings this afternoon. That was a rocket right at the microphone and went right over the left shoulder. That top spin, all that. No, if I've got electrical devices in the way, it can only be a deflection, harmful to my health, not a chance. Oh, 2 pitch, just outside. Somebody said, whose team are you on, ref? Wrong sport. 10-6 Redbirds, we are in the ninth inning. Beck trying to put away the pinch hitter, and he does. He gets Solarte swinging. And we're down to the last out. And this will be Sierra. Came on to play left last inning. So Ellis stands to pick up the win today for the Redbirds. Sierra slashes this one foul to the left side. Sierra at 286, a homer and 6 RBIs. Has spent a good part of the year at AA Jacksonville. Field slants towards left as he takes inside a ball and a strike. One more to go. Draw even in this series. That should do it. A 2-hopper for the birthday boys. Had a big time. Stand and cheer them on, folks. Nice comeback win when the Redbirds were down 5-0 midway through this game. They come back to win it by a score of 10-6. That's what they talk about. Let's line up and shake some hands today, boys, when they come out of the clubhouse. And we'll be back to give you the final totals after this on CW30.